My name is Aaron Malloy, and today I'll be going into my last video blog, which is 6-1, and today we'll be talking about neo-evolution. Now, this topic is kind of interesting because, you know, going from my background and following more of the biblical terms and stuff, it's kind of interesting because it goes more into the future and with neo-evolution and what it has, you know, where it's at now and where it's going to be at in the future. It's kind of mostly the scary point of where we are and how as we think and where it's going. So neo-evolution is a scientific theory claiming that evolution is an ongoing process that is continuing to occur in the present day. And I mean, there's so many things you can actually look at, and later on I'll be going into an example of that. Humankind has been altering its biological evolution for thousands of years by manipulating, developing tools and other technologies to enhance our abilities. I mean, you look at our, you know, neo-evolution's been starting since the 1930s and on. And there's always been those scientific theories of where we're going and where they, you know, they want us to be at later on in the future. Neo-evolution is not just natural, but we actually control it. We guide it. It's what we make it. And, you know, looking at things that we can control and what we can't control, especially going into with this course and where we're going. It's pretty scary to think that, you know, when you think about robots, when you think about, you know, if your arm gets cut off, they can put an arm there or actually genetically have an arm grow back and probably be stronger than the next arm you actually have. The example of a technology that's altering or may alter human evolution, I'm going to talk about the microchip implant for the humans. Now, obviously, when you think about microchip implants, I mostly think about dogs and cats that actually have them. And it's actually similar, but in more detail. With the dog and cats, with the microchip, you're only able to actually implant it in there, and it's only to a certain length that you can actually track them. So if it's 100 yards, it stops right there. With the human implant, they actually install it under the skin, and it's kind of like a grain of rice. And when you think about it, it's kind of scary because, I mean, sooner or later, you know, we actually might not have a choice. And right now they're doing a lot of tests. People are actually, you know, giving their rights up and installing these microchips in there. And it's not something within time you can just remove. You know, when you grow up, it's going to be a part of you pretty much. And you can pretty much be tracked anywhere you go. Some of the potential benefits of this technology is tracking your kids. That's huge because you think about it, there's always predators out there and you want to be able to know where your kids are at all times. A lot of people actually put this in them, put this in their babies or their children so it can actually, they can know where their kid is at all times. Again, preventing potential kidnapping, that's another big thing with having this type of technology and actually utilizing it. This is actually would be useful for patients, medical IDs, you know, passports, you know, where you don't have to carry these things. It can just scan your skin and you can enter another country and they know who you are. Which, again, scary, but, you know, those are one of the potential benefits of this technology. Another one is being able to use to enter your everyday life, your car. Imagine you can just scan your window and your car starts up, or you scan it and it shuts off, or your house. You want to enter your house. You don't need to use keys. You just scan it and you're just able to enter your house. You know, and I think these are definitely technologies that are potentially going to expand. And, you know, sooner or later, it will be bigger than what it is right now. A couple of potential drawbacks of this is feeling like a slave. I mean, you know, there's nothing that you would want where you're just being controlled on where you're at, what you're doing. If you could enter this place or enter that place and by them scanning your skin, your human rights are actually being violated, in my opinion. And there's no, and you basically have no more freedom. It goes into the whole aspect of the New World Order and what they're trying to do. And with Bill Gates and a couple other people that's been working right now on trying to get implants in every human being. And they want to control what we are actually doing. And, you know, this goes into a whole bio, a bio where, you know, they can actually, you know, implant these things in you and you're not even knowing. You know, and that actually is, you know, violating your human rights. Another issue is, you know, your privacy, and you're actually not able to just get up and go. Everybody can actually track and know exactly where you're at. Again, there's good and bads of this actual chip. But being inside your skin and knowing where you're going, what's what, it just messes up the whole entire purpose of being a human being. When I think of being a human being, I think of freedom. I think of, you know, being a part of nature. And now with our mindsets, we're actually controlling what we are actually doing, which is in no way, shape, or form, right? And that goes into the whole thing of the biblical prophecies of, you know, with the mark of the beast, and there's so many other potential things that you can really get into that are potential drawbacks of this. One of the biggest reasons is, you know, you can get sick. I mean, you can develop probably cancer. There's definitely, when you think of something that's electrical in your body, it's electrical hazard. And even though there's probably doctors who have done so many testings and things like that, we're still human. And being human, we can adapt to things, but sometimes our bodies can't adapt. And sometimes we don't really know how we are and how we're going to feel towards things. one thing that looking at our moral and ethical implications of the neo-evolution is with the chip is actually understanding where it's actually going, what we are actually doing, you know, and the potential drawbacks of stopping us on living our lives. And, you know, looking at other examples of the neo-evolution, like birth control, you know, stopping, you know, people from having kids and going into a certain direction and controlling what life for me is more about, you know, nature. It's about, you know, just letting things be. And, you know, later on in the future, we tend to actually have where we're controlling our way of thinking, controlling our way of living, you know, where, you know, it's been like this for years. We have, you know, flu shots. We put this toxin actually in our body that stops us from getting the flu shot. And, you know, it kills our immune system, you know, and I feel like that is a perfect example of what, you know, of where things are right now. So this has been going on for years now. And they tell you, okay, you have to get these things done. You know, just like with the chip, you have to get this. You're going to, later on in the future, they're going to tell you, you have to get this chip in your arm in order to purchase food, or in order to get gas, you have to have this chip in you. So they're going to force us to get to this point. And it's important for us to actually educate ourselves and knowing where we're going with this technology. Should we continue to pursue this form of technology? You know, it's kind of interesting because, again, there's goods and there's bads. I think you should have the right to say no. I don't believe in forcing people to do something. You know, I could understand if people are, you know, in jail and they put a chip in them to know where they're at. You know, I could understand that. But being a part of this is our earth. This is our world. This is our, you know, our freedom. We shouldn't have to sit there and look at these certain technologies that can affect us and what we're doing on our everyday living. I don't believe in holding us back in because of technology. Technology shouldn't have to control us. And that's what I feel like with the neo-evolution, that's what it's actually doing. It's controlling us. Yes, there's goods. Yes, of course. If I was to have a kid and I could say, hey, I want a son. I want my son to be strong. I want my son to to be healthy. That would be awesome. But then, are we really, I feel like we're really playing with our lives. And it's something that can definitely hinder us from getting to where we need to go in life. Modern technology may be affecting our human evolution. You know, looking at where we're going with everything, look at our, you know, it could affect our immune system. It could make us weaker. With our continued dependence of medication for survival combined with whatever methods to prolong good health, our immune system will be less equipped to handle diseases on its own. And we are continuously to utilize technology in order for us to live. And sooner or later, this is when robots come into play. This is when technology takes over our human, you know, self-well-being. And that is not good in my eyes. Another thing is our memory capability will be gone. I mean, now that there's a wealth and knowledge literally at our fingertips, there's less of a burden for us to store and retain as much as information as we once did. There's certain things that, there's certain tests that has been done with memories of young people today are worse than the parents were at their age. So when you think about it, these young kids, their memories are not as strong. And this goes into the whole world of reading a book, educating yourself, building your cells and being smarter. And now that the more technology is out, it's controlling our well of thinking. It's controlling what we're actually doing. Just like when these chips are inside us, it's controlling us. It, by all means, if we don't really know what it's actually doing, the doctors can say, yes, it won't affect us. But they're getting paid to say that. They're not really telling us the real inside of it. And we won't learn until later on. So that's with neo-evolution, it's kind of scary to know that what these things can actually do, and yes, it can make us smarter, stronger, it can help us identify ourselves, it can help us know our locations, but is it really safe? That's the big question, and that's, you know, that's one of the biggest things that when I think about it, it kind of makes you understand where our future is and where we're actually going. And it doesn't look good for us as humans. We're going to embrace technology very hard. And with neo technology, it's going to go to the next generations. From 100 years from now, you know, we might be all robots for all I know. You know, they might control us on how many kids you can actually have. In certain countries, you can only have a certain amount of kids. You know, sooner or later, they might say you only could have one per adult or one per household, you know, and they will control what you're doing. Just like right now, they're doing that right now, but in more in a smaller standpoint. So going back to more of the neo-evolution and being a scientific theory, we control it. The technology doesn't control us. We make the technology, but sooner or later, technology is going to control what we do. The technology is going to control how we think, because sooner or later, technology is going to outgrow us. Technology is going to take over our minds and have a mind of its own. And that's the thing that we have to be careful about. With microchip and implants in humans, it's the same thing. Sooner or later, it's going to be in all of us. And what are we actually going to do about it? You know, are we just going to settle? That's what a lot of times as humans we tend to do, is just settle and say, okay, that's just us. That's our way of living. We have to get used to it. And we don't know how to fight for it, fight for our rights. And it's you know, for me, I love technology. I love what it has to bring, but as long as it's safe. And looking at how we think, and we do think outside the box, which is a good thing, but knowing where it's actually going startles me. Knowing that technology sooner or later will take over our jobs scares me. Knowing that technology sooner or later, you know, cars are going to be driving on their own. And, you know, yes, there's goods and bads between those things. But what about the people who actually enjoy driving? What about the people who actually enjoy nature, who wants to be off the grid? Now you're not going to be able to be off the grid because you're going to have a chip on you. And then, okay, let's say you say, no, I don't want this chip in me. Are you considered as a rogue? Are you considered as a rebel because you're not adapting to what what we consider as the do's and the don'ts? You know, so it's very interesting. And, you know, with where everything is actually going, it will be interesting to see where we'll be at in the next couple of years. For me, you know, like I said, I'm a very spiritual person. So I do pray, I do meditate, and I do pray for our technology, and hoping that there's more pros into our neo evolution and people start to utilize it the correct way. Thank you.